all the dignitaries on the dais, and my dear student managers. Sir Adarsh Mishra is the director and CHRO at Panasonic India. Sir has contributed his excellence on professional grounds at Panasonic India since 2013 in human resource, as part of leadership team in driving business and people agenda. Sir is full-time focusing on developing leadership pools for future business growth, building performance-oriented culture along with innovation and creativity. Sir has robust experience at LG Electronics for 13 years as DGM Corporate HR, where the key focus was on employee branding, employee engagement, and culture building. Sir has attained ample of accomplishments in his professional journey. To name a few, he led various Six Sigma projects, career planning, and talent management, etc. Sir even had experience with Jindal Steel and Power Limited as assistant manager, HR, for 5 years. Sir, the audience is eager for your address, sir, and looking forward for your today's session. The stage is all yours, sir.
Very good evening to all of you. Vibrant Balaji. It is such a pleasure to be today. And when I come back here, I'm coming after 3 years. And when I look back, the first time I came to this institute was in 2001. Almost 18, 19 years back, when I used to work for a company called LG Electronics. And that was your first batch in Nishanwadi. And during those days, you know, the campus was in a school. It was run in a school. And the school used to get over at 6 o'clock in the evening, and the classes used to start from the evening. And I used to reach the campus for the placements at around 11, 11:30, 12. And we had a very special, you know, connect with Bala sir. We are really impressed the way he was trying to drive his mission, the hard work, the effort, the passion he had. So that was a point. And LG was a big brand, and a lot of companies, a lot of institutes used to invite us. We used to go there. But the connect which we developed with Balaji never happened anywhere else. And continuously, we kept on visiting Balaji. And whatever Bala sir always says, that, you know, you guys came and you supported us during our time of difficulty. Because when you start an institute, you look for placements. But I said, no. You created students, you gave to us, and that made our life easy, and we got rewarded and got promoted and got elevated. So that was something, you know, which was a very important integral part of the relationship. We continued, and best part was that Bala sir never expected any numbers. He never pushed for any candidate, never. And that was the driving force to have this relationship going on. Because many institutes you go, you know, people propose, take this guy, they do that. And we're very clean, and we stopped going to some of the big names I don't want to take here. We simply stopped going there because they used to push. The kind of discipline Bala sir was bringing the students, because industry was going through a transformation that point of time. And 24 years, I think, I have spent in the industry. Many of you would not have born that time. But I don't look that old, huh? Yeah. So, you know, the industry was going through that transformation. And Bala sir, his style was very different. 365 days classes. And a Korean organization like LG was very, very demanding. He was making the students ready, and used to picking big numbers. And today also, many of them are there handling big profiles. Many of them joined me in Panasonic when I came. They had gone out of LG and they were working somewhere else, and then they approached and they came. So we are a big pool, and we all are connected. The social media, thanks to the social media, we all are there. And few of them are still working with me in my team. So Pew is, she's in Pune, but she could not come here because we had some interviews. So she was a 2007 pass batch, and she's from HR, and today she's a business HR head, and she's managing the entire recruitment and business transformation for Panasonic India. And we have ultimate, I mean, 5-6 companies under Panasonic. It is not only consumer durables, but other companies also. She's responsible for everything. So she has around 12 years experience and managing a very important portfolio. So the culture, what I mean to say, the culture which was inculcated in the beginning years is really paying off well for her also. So there are many, many such cases. And Abhinav Saran, and it used to happen, I don't know, the presidents used to get selected, I don't know why. And Bala sir used to ask me that, I never give you any hint. How do you pick the, what is the trick? How do you pick the presidents? So last, in the first 4 years, the presidents got selected. And they set a very good example. And why does, you know, companies build a relationship with the institute? Because it is because of the connect, the kind of, you know, the kind of effort and the kind of performance students give. So that was the history. Now, while coming, I was, in fact, when Dimple ma'am called me, you know, last week, I was supposed to be here on Friday, but got stuck up somewhere, could not come. So I asked her, what do I need to talk? She said that, no, do you need any presentation? She said, no, you just come and share your experiences. So while coming, I just jotted on some points that what I need to talk to you, because you guys are coming for, I understand you have spent only a couple of days now before you joined. So I thought that today's youth is tomorrow's leader, because, you know, once you pass out from this campus, obviously you will be picking up a career somewhere, and definitely in your career, you will be leading teams in times to come. So how the industry is going to take shape, what things you need to keep in mind. And whatever I'm going to say, nothing will be new. I will just reinforce with my experience. Maybe that will be helpful for you. So maybe you can pick some question, I mean, some thoughts, food for thought for yourself, ponder upon it, and maybe that will be useful for you. And I believe in speaking from my heart. So I don't believe in talking or, you know, giving stories, no. So no jargons. So I speak from here. So that is how you can connect. So that is about it. So today, the power of youth is such that it is a very, very important part of the bouquet. You know, in a bouquet, you have all kinds of flowers. So youth is a very important and integral part of the bouquet. So there is no denial on it. Now, the youth has force, hope and leaders. They are the of tomorrow. And if you talk about the future generation, now half of India is below 25 years. And the average age of this country will be around 29 years by 2020. Japan would be somewhere around 47 years. Europe would be somewhere around 46 years. US around 42 years. China is also catching up and they are also getting older, 40 years, average age. So India has a big potential with 29 years. Average age. So when you have young people, so they are going to be competition, and the competition is going to be immense. Of course, investment is going to come in India with the new government coming in, lot of hard work going into, things are going to change, and the environment context is changing very, very, very fast. So we all need to align ourselves. Now, if you talk about the backbone of the nation society, education is the best tool for success, because when the British left us in 1947, that point of time, the literacy rate was around 16%. Now it is 74%. And when I say this, there are four elements of E. The first is expansion. So a lot of institutes mushroomed. A lot of institutes in last so many years came up across, you know, I mean, it was MBA institutes, engineering institutes, architecture, in every field. So expansion happened in a very big way. Then we had engaging, where the citizens, people, they all engaged with the institute. Then we had excellence, with coming up of IITs, IIMs, and institute like yours. There was a lot of focus on quality, that how do you bring quality. And then the most important thing was employability. So while coming, while I was sitting with Biju sir, I was talking to him and I was sharing that whenever I, you know, interact with CEOs and CHROs, so they always say that, you know, I mean, we are not very happy with the kind of, you know, talent we are getting. they had some complaints about the youth. When they handle the youth, what are the challenges they face? And recently I was reading a survey where they said that 74% people, they say that they are not very happy. So I tried to dig that what is that which, you know, is bothering, and with my experience, because I've been hiring students from last so many years, you know, so at times people are a bit restless, they want to take shortcuts, they don't have patience. Of course, they are very creative people, they have a lot of passion, very talented, there's no doubt about it. But unfortunately, our youth today is in a hurry. So that is one aspect we definitely need to, you know, understand. So now in the industry, there will be four generations working together. So we had the baby boomers, people like me. Then we had Gen X. Then we had millennials. And now the Gen Z. Four generations working. And for industry, for organizations, it's very, very difficult to manage four kind of generations, you know. Expectations are different. Requirements are different. So it's a big challenge. People, it's an era of smartphones, era of social media, and everything has its strengths and weaknesses. So as youth, we all need to understand, we all need to feel responsible. We all need to understand the importance of social media. That is very, very important. You all should be connected. But there has to be a limit to whatever you do. If it is within the limit, it is fine. So you need to take care of this. And whatever I'm saying, as I said, is nothing new. Your teachers, your parents, your, you know, elders would have taught you. But this is a reinforcement, as I said. Train your eyes that what tomorrow will look like. So you need to visualize, you need to understand how the industry is going to shape. You need to do a lot of study, a lot of research. Use your time productively. Spend time with your friends, colleagues, discussing, you know, these issues. That's very, very important. Talk to your seniors. Be in touch with your seniors. Be in touch with people, those who have joined in the industry. Don't think that, you know, I've just entered, it's 2 years. After 2 years, I'll try to, you know, find what is happening in industry. Of course, you will be doing your server placements, you'll be visiting organizations, you'll come to know, but be in touch with your seniors. So, you know, sometime back, I was reading somewhere, maybe some many years back, in fact. So it was a story about a pencil box, you know, the pencils. So the pencils get packed and then it is sent to the market. So the maker of a pencil gives a story. He says that the first thing is that allow yourself to be held in someone's hand. So you need to have a mentor. You need to have somebody who will always coach you, who will always guide you whenever you require, and be approachable, be available. So this is a very, very important aspect. And you will always remember this story. Of course, the story is very long, but I have tried to summarize it so that you can always refer to whenever you want to. The second was, experience a painful sharpening from time to time to become a better pencil. That is, going through the grind. Because pencil, you know, sharpening hoti hai na, kaam likhne ke liye. So, ab jaise likhoge, aap sharpen karoge, it's very tough. So that is the grind. So you should be prepared to go through the grind as a pencil. The third was ability to correct your mistakes. Every pencil has a rubber at the back. So whenever you make a mistake, you should have that ability to correct your mistakes. Then the most important thing in a pencil is what? Batao, koi bata sakta hai kya? Lead. That is your knowledge. Without lead, a pencil is meaningless. Always try to upgrade yourself, reskill yourself. This is very, very, very important aspect. Whether you are in industry, you are doing something of your own, whatever you are doing, upgradation is very, very important. And continue to write whatever may come. So, and whatever you do, leave a legacy. When you move ahead in life, do something good, leave a footmark so that your juniors, when they come, they feel proud that, okay, this is my senior who has done this, whether you are in corporate or in, you know, academia. keep these things into mind. You are like a pencil, and you have been made for great things. Now, about sharing about my experience, you know, I was brought up in a culture which was Tata, and you know, in Tatas they have a very rich culture where a father joins a job and then they offer a job to the ward also. I don't know how many people Tata ke bahut sare honge yahan par. Yes, so Tata has this culture. Ab nahi hai mere khayal se, pehle hamare zamane mein hota tha. It used to happen. So when I was offered this, you know, HR role only, so I said no, I don't want to take this job. I want to do something of my own. I want to choose my own destiny, and whatever company I join, whether it is small or it is big, I'm least bothered about brand. I want to join a company which will give me learnings, and I will want to explore myself, whether it is small or big, it does not matter. Then I joined a company called Jindal Steel under Mr. Naveen Jindal. It was in Raigarh, it was a steel plant. I joined there as a management trainee, and when I joined there, in 2-3 months time, you know, my boss Naveen Jindal saw me somewhere, and then he spotted me, and then he, you know, offered me to assist him during his time when he used to fly from Delhi to Raigarh. I started working with him along with my additional profile of HR, connect with the chief ministers and the, you know, commissioners, collectors, and not only HR job. I used to do all kind of job, whether it was power plant generation, or it was steel melting shops, or it was mining, or it was land acquisition, anything. So as a HR professional, you know, people used to tell me, what are you doing? And that time, you know, I was very young like you. So people used to pollute my ears that you are spending so much time, it is not going to pay you. But I don't know, somehow I got, you know, stuck to the work, and I used to enjoy. And today I realize that whatever I did that time is paying me when I'm heading this company, because I have to handle this kind of issues. There are a lot of crisis handling, and those experiences are really, you know, helping me to take decisions. So whatever you do doesn't get waste. This is what I want to say. Whenever you join a company, be very open. Of course, you should have a vision in mind. You should have an ambition in mind, but you should be flexible. So that was one very important learning. Then I came and joined LG in 2000. And then that time LG was very new entrant in the company country, and we were setting up the R&D plant. We were setting up the sales channel, the marketing channel, the innovation channel, everything. And moving from a typical Indian company to a multinational company, the expectation was very different. So it is all about mindset, that how fast you adapt. Again, that really helped me. The Koreans were very different, very demanding, very fast, very swift. And if you are aligned, if you have a clear vision, and if you are enjoying and if you are loving a job, you will never feel, you know, stressed, you will never feel burdened. So that really helped me. So that is also very important. So never get bogged down whenever you change. You should be adaptable. Adaptability is very, very important. And in this process, in the 13 years, the learning was immense. And that is how, you know, I got connected with so many, you know, seniors, and learned from them. That was very important. And then, you know, a few lessons from my professional journey was taking charge. I talked about destiny. I took charge. Then earn your happiness, because a rupee earned with hard work is much more, you know, you get a lot of pleasure than earning 5 rupees. You know, somebody gives you 5 rupees. So hard earned money, you know, it really pays well. That is very, very important. Nothing succeeds like failure. You should enjoy your winning habits, but you should be very humble. That is very important thing. Humility is very important thing, because I am in HR. I keep on getting complaints from the market that the sales guy has come and he owns a brand like LG or a Panasonic, you know, a big brand. Somebody goes and misbehaves with the dealers and distributors at times, you know. So that is not done, because if a person starts doing that, it gives a bad name, not only to the brand, but to the individual also. So, I mean, whatever I'm saying, of course, you have to spend 2 years in the institute, but this is going to really help you in times to come. Then, always play to win. This is very, very important. You know, playing to win brings a lot of, it best, best in you. It allows you to stretch. At times, you know, we get customized, we say that no, we have achieved our goal, it is fine, you feel contented, you don't stretch. This is very, very important. But to win, it is very important that you be within your value system. So values are going to play a very, very important role in your times to come in life, in your future life. And it may sound a bit comical, but I would like to believe that, you know, in the war of Kurukshetra, so Lord Krishna could have, you know, preferred to be in any team, whether Kauravas or Pandavas, but he conspired the entire situation in such a way that he was with Arjuna. Because, you know, he was the strongest Kshatriya and he wanted to be safe, probably, with Arjuna. Unko bhi dar tha ki Arjuna ka safe rahunga main shayad. So, the Rig Veda has delivered a very unspoken message and it says that if you want God to be with you, you have to be good with what you do. भगवान उसी के साथ रहता है, उसी का सहायता करता है जो खुद की सहायता करता है. हमने सुना है ना, ये फैक्ट है. दिस इज फैक्ट ऑफ लाइफ. सो आई हैव दिस, दिस व्हाट आई हैव लर्न थ्रू आउट माय यू नो करियर. एंड इफ यू आर द बेस्ट, गॉड विल डू द रेस्ट. दिस इज वेरी वेरी सिंपल. लाइफ को बहुत सिंपल रखना, जितना आप सिंपल रखोगे उतनी अच्छी है. देयर इज नो नीड टू यू नो कॉम्प्लेक्स योर लाइफ. कीप इट वेरी सिंपल. वी in the HR fitness talk about a VUCA world. VUCA is volatile, uncertain, complex, ambiguous. Business is going to get complex. The workplace is going to change. The dynamics are going to change. We all need to prepare ourselves. We definitely need to prepare ourselves. As I said, that we need to scale up. We need to reskill up. So that is a very important aspect. Keep innovating. Keep reading. A lot of transformation is happening. Digital transformation is happening. You need to keep pace with the changing environment, because when you join a company and when you grow, the ladder becomes very thin. So very few people reach the top. And there is a very thin line gap between good and great. So you need to manage that also. And somebody was asking me that, you know, while we are coming, so few of your seniors, they had gone to, you know, assist me here. So, one of them asked me that, when you recruit people, what do you see in them? So, my answer was very simple. Whenever I recruit people, I see only two elements. One is ambition. The person has to be ambitious. And second is, he has to be humble. Because if you are ambitious, you will have passion. You will have all elements to be successful. That is very important. But it is very important to be humble. Very, very important. And before I conclude, I would like to narrate a story. In fact, I had seen a video some time back. So it is a story about a carpenter in North America. A carpenter tha North America mein, and he was around 35 years of age. So after working for 35 years, he thought that now it is time for me to retire. And then he went to his boss and he knocked the door and he said, "Boss, I want to talk to you something very personal." And his boss said, "What? Please carry on. Batao aap kya chahiye?" So he said, "Ke boss, main to 35 saal kaam kar chuka, aapka seva kar chuka, maine bahut kuch diya aapko. Now it is time for me to retire, spend time with my family, with my grandchildren. And I want to rest." So boss ne kaha ki, "Dekh lo, you can still work. You have that capability and competency abhi bhi hai." He said, "No boss, ab mujhe jane dijiye. 35 saal bahut hota hai. Let me, you know, relax." She said, "Okay, finally if you have decided, you can carry on. But I have one request, that I have a last project. Please complete this house and then go." Mani man socha, ab kya karun? बॉस ने अब जाना था, रोक लिया, अब चलो कर लेता हूँ. बड़े दुखी मन से ही एक्सेप्टेड. इट वॉज वेरी सैड, बट ही एक्सेप्टेड. एंड देन ही स्टार्टेड वर्किंग डे एंड नाइट. देर वॉज नो इंटरेस्ट. इंटरेस्ट था नहीं. कहाँ से मटेरियल आ रहा है, क्या डिज़ाइन है, क्या सुपरविजन है. ही वॉज लीस्ट बॉदर्ड. एंड सम हाउ ही कम्प्लीटेड द प्रोजेक्ट. सो ही केम टू हिज बॉस and said, "Boss, I have completed and now I want to be relieved. Please relieve me." The boss said, "Okay, baithiye aap." And then he offered a tea. And then he opened the drawer of his table. He took out a key and gave it to that gentleman that aapne hamari seva ki hai itne saalon tak. Ye aapka parting gift hai. Jo ghar aapne banaya hai, ye ghar hamare paas aapko gift hai. And that guy was like, you know, he said that, "Oh shit, had I known, kaash mujhe pata hota ki jo main ghar bana raha hu, ye ghar mujhe hi milne wala hai, kaash." And he kept on repenting, but he could not change what had happened. So ye story hum sabke life mein hoti hai, and as students, aap कभी रिपेंट मत करना कि काश मैंने पढ़ाई की होती, काश बिजू सर की बात सुनी होती, काश बाला सर की बात मानी होती, अपने प्रोफेसर्स की बात मानी होती. बिकॉज यू नो, सो दिस व्हाई आई चोज टू शेयर द स्टोरी इज दैट इट इज़ अ वेरी सिंपल स्टोरी, बट यू कैन रिमेंबर दिस फॉर योर होल लाइफ इफ यू वॉन्ट टू. दैट वॉट एवर यू डू, यू शुड डू फॉर पैशन. यू नेवर नो, इट विल कम बैक टू यू. हर काम में लर्निंग होती है, हर काम अच्छा होता है, कोई काम खराब नहीं होता है. एंड यू आर वेरी फॉर्चुनेट एंड यू आर वेरी लकी दैट यू हैव जॉइन दिस इंस्टीट्यूट. आई मस्ट से दैट बिकॉज द काइंड ऑफ या बिकॉज द काइंड ऑफ लर्निंग यू आर गोइंग टू गेट हियर, इट इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी टफ, वेरी ग्रिलिंग, बट डेफिनेटली इट विल ब्रिंग लॉट ऑफ वैल्यू टू यू. Lot of value to you. And you will feel proud. You will make your parents feel proud. I'm very sure about it. Your teachers feel proud about it. And one thing which is very, very important, always keep this in mind. And as I always say, that attitude and not aptitude will determine your altitude. Matlab, aapka attitude, aapke aptitude se ज़्यादा बड़ा है, जो आपकी एल्टीट्यूड डिसाइड करेगा विच इज़ योर हाइट, द ग्रोथ वी आर गोइंग टू अटेन इन योर प्रोफेशनल जर्नी. एंड बिफोर आई एंड, इन फैक्ट आई वॉन्टेड टू अनाउंस दैट फ्रॉम दिस ईयर बिजू सर विल अगेन कम फॉर द कैंपसेस एंड so last 2 years we did not come because we were in the process of building a pedigree, and we have been hiring from IIMs and IITs. So that was a global direction because we wanted to send people, so we wanted to have a mix of people from all kind of institutes. So 2 years was a focus, and I had told this to Bala sir in fact 3 years back only, that 2 years will not be coming. But of course we were engaged, summer trainees and all those things were already happening. And we'll keep continuing, and this relationship will blossom years on years. Thank you so much. Wish you all the best and do well in life. If you have any questions in mind, any one of you, if you want to understand, if you want to ask anything, you are free. Yes. Very good question, very intelligent question. Look, about Panasonic in India, people see Panasonic only from a consumer durable brand. Of course, our 75% of the business comes from consumer durable, but we have multiple businesses like B2B, we are very strong in energy storage devices, that is the batteries, the electronic, you can have your seat please. So the electronic vehicle, the Tesla motor, we have set up a plant in US. We are 60% of the batteries are Panasonic made there. In India, we have brought that technology here. In India, we are into connected solutions. We are into automotive. We are into, you know, energy solutions. A lot of businesses are there. Consumer durable, of course, is 75%. Anchor Electric is also one of our companies. And they do very good business and they generate huge profits also. They are based out of Bombay. And consumer durable business, to support the consumer durable business, we have set up a R&D lab in Bangalore. It is called India Innovation Center. So we have a concept of Pana Home. None of the competition has this concept of Pana Home, because in Japan, Panasonic, except for brick and mortar, for a house, they are into everything. Whether it is your cables, your lights, your fans, your solar panels, your floor tiles, your bathroom solutions, your kitchen solutions, your air conditioner, washing machine, appliances, anything. They are into everything. So we are getting into aggressively into Pana Homes. And we have recently set up, we had a factory. We have recently set up a refrigerator plant in Jhajjar, Haryana. So we manufacture air conditioners, we manufacture refrigerators, washing machine, we manufacture welding machines, robotic welding machines. We manufacture audio systems, speakers, all those things. So after refrigerator plant, the demand, and it's doing very well, the demand is going to go bigger. So we were earlier importing from Thailand. We have a big factory in Thailand and Malaysia. And, you know, importing from there is a challenge. So that is one aspect which will help us to, you know, and in air conditioners this year, we have grown by around 45% as compared to last year. Of course, the you know, we had a strong lineup, and then the weather condition also supported us, and we had done some strategic changes. Xiaomi, of course, they have come and they are trying to, you know, disrupt the market. And in competition, it is very, very important, because unless and until you have this disruption, you will never innovate. So at times, you know, competition pushes you to innovate, and we are already geared up. And Xiaomi currently is playing on online, but online, till how long will it sustain? They will face the burn when they get into the offline, where you have to manage the dealers, the distributors, your channel partners, you have to put FIS to sell your products, where you have to do a lot of promotions. How they are going to manage that? And now China is struggling in a big way. So the Chinese government is supporting these companies in a, I mean, they're funding these companies. But how long will it continue? But yeah, we are doing our own research, and we have already taken actions. And I think we are very competent, and we are very sure that these threats are coming. Of course, it is a part of the business. It's going to come. But Manish sir himself, you know, our CEO is around 48 years of old. Very young and very enterprising person. So whatever he says, he means it. Yeah.
Experience helps you in your future growth.
Have a seat. See, when I was in Jindal, I was very young that time, only 2-3 years of experience. And since I was working in the vice chairman's secretariat, and you know, assisting him to handle liaisoning and legal and HR related work, the biggest challenge was to give confidence to people, because we were coming up with the power plant, and power plant needed a lot of water. And we had a river called, Kelo, yeah, river. And during summers, the river used to get dry, and people were very scared. So they were not very sure that if this company is going to come, they are going to take the water. So wahan par Chhattisgarh is a, you know, state, unfortunately, people have been, I mean, the government in the earlier time, they had not spent so much, and people were very illiterate. But they were not very, you know, I mean, informed, very well informed. Unko kisne keh diya ki wo pani se bijli nikal lenge, pani rahega nahi, and all these talks were going on. So what we did, we constituted 4 teams. And you'll not believe that in the nights, because in the daytime, all the political parties used to go and brainwash them. So in the night, we used to visit all the sarpanches with them. We used to go to houses. We used to educate people. And in around 40-45 days, we gave them confidence that, of course, we offered them job. Whenever you do rehabilitation, you offer jobs. So that was already there. But apart from that, we gave them a lot of incentives. We gave them a message. Then we brought them to our to the campus. We showed them the colonies. We showed them the factory. We gave them a presentations. We made them understand ki ye jo bhi cheez phailai ja rahi hai galat hai. And in that process, you learn a lot, because it is not a effort which you do one time and it happens. You have to continuously do that. And where the political parties, the press media, and what happened, unfortunately, there was a hunger strike and one of the ladies, she died. She was an old age. And there was a big UN cry. How to manage the media? How to manage the crisis? How you maneuver? And without being, even without doing anything wrong. Because if you do anything wrong, people will not trust you. They'll get to know. So you have to be very, very clear. Because my CEO was very clear. Mr. GDS Sohal, a Sikh gentleman. He was a CEO, a very, very seasoned professional. So he said that whatever you are saying, deliver that. Even if it is small, deliver that. There we did a lot of welfare camps, eye cure camps, free of cost. A lot of camps we did. Then, putting up hand pumps, building schools, all those things. So that brought people together. And today, I think they are doing very well. They have the world's longest rail mill today. They have 1,000 megawatt power plant was being set up there. Now it is around 1,800 megawatt power plant. They have rolling mill. They have blast furnaces. They have turbines. Everything is there. So the company has grown like anything. So that was the biggest learning, that whenever you have difficulty, crisis, you should have patience and never give up. And be very true to yourself. Don't try to manipulate things, because at the end of the day, people understand. So trust is very important. So what we did, village to village trust, we created that. So that was very tough. But then we had a strategy in place. So we gave them security and then trust. That was there.
Sir, I would like to question, what is the way forward under the branding aspect of Panasonic India and with addition of your experience?
Well, for a consumer durable brand, Panasonic was actually seen as a mom and pop brand. It has been in India for a very long time. And people used to relate with their parents' brand. Then to give a youthfulness, we brought Ranbir Kapoor, Katrina Kaif, and Dia Mirza. So they were our brand ambassadors to give a fresh perspective. So that relationship continued for a very long time. And branding and product, it goes hand in hand. So whenever you brand a product, according to youth, you have to develop that product also. So as I said, that India Innovation Center is playing a very important role. And then we have a lot of campaigns happening. During the Diwali time, you would have seen. During the season time, you would have seen. We do a lot of print. A lot of ATL and a lot of BTL activities are being done. A lot of corporate social responsibility activities have been done in the regions. A lot of activities are being done at the global level. In India, we hold a golf tournament, which is very, 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 very popular in Delhi. That happens in the month of January, February. And where a lot of golfers from abroad come and play. So this is a continuous journey. And we are committed, and this is going to carry on. Yeah. Thank you. कोई बात नहीं, गुड मॉर्निंग, चलो। Okay. So I'll reply to the second question first. Please have your seat. We are very strong in solar panel business. The only challenge is that cost for Panasonic, because if you talk about the life of our panels are very long as compared to the life of the Chinese, Chinese players. So recently we have got a big order from the Punjab government for setting up a solar panel plant in Punjab. But we are evaluating that, because there are certain technicalities where Japan is directly, because we are not manufacturing those cells here. Those cells are being manufactured in Japan. So the delivery is an issue there. So we are working with the Punjab government, and in times to come, I think more than panels, our strategy is to work in energy storage devices. Because today, India is not a energy deprived state anymore, electricity deprived anymore. What is important is a lot of energy is being, generated. How do you store the energy? So we are using lithium and batteries to store this energy. So our focus is more on lithium and batteries. So that is response to your second question. About expectation from the young mind is, we want people to be, ambitious. We want people to be patient. Because the biggest problem is that, you hire people, you train them, you groom them, and after 1 year say that my colleague in that company has got this much rise and he's doing this, I want to go there or I want to change. So when you change a job, there has to be a purpose. So stability is one thing. So we expect people from the young people that they need to continuously innovate, and they should have that perseverance and patience to wait, not to take shortcuts. So that is very, very important. And in Panasonic, we run a campaign called Vibrant Panasonic. So this campaign is about, a 10-year plan which we announced. It is to move from engagement to well-being to happiness of people. It is all about culture transformation. And it is really helping us, because 5 years back when we started, we used to lose around 18% of the employees every year. And now after 5 years, that has come to around 12%. So what we do here, we do a lot of activities. Team lunches are there, fun days are there, knowledge sharing sessions are there, high tea with the president and CEO is there. We have an internal social media on SAP Jam. SAP is a platform and we call it Ripples. So people post their issues, their good things, if there is something bad, we promote people to be very, very open. So this is really helping the youth, because the average age of a company is 29 years only, a very young company. So when you have a young talent, young pool, you had many, difficulties also to meet their aspirations, their individual development plan, their career development plan, where they would see themselves 5 years from now. So those are some of the challenges, but we are meeting them very efficiently. So that is how, when you are able to communicate to the employee that this is what we are doing for you, that trust element, it really helps them to build that confidence and continue. So from the organization side, of course, the company is investing heavily. And from the youth, our expectation is that they should always try to innovate, try to do things differently. Maybe if you are doing a certain thing in one way, we should not feel that that is only the right way. There can be some other way also. So always try to innovate. And about Six Sigma, during my LG days, when I was given the project of Six Sigma, I used to think, what can a HR do? HR guy contribute. But ultimately, I did Six Sigma projects, and it really helped me to think analytically. Today, when I, take some decisions, I always analyze. So, as I said, that every, job brings you learning. So that is it.
So my question to you is, like you said, we have 4 generations of employees working together in the concept of VUCA coming into corporate world. What policies are HR formulating as to cope up with these challenges? And are there any new policies that you might be working on to handle the new generation of employees?
We have a learning and development team So learning and development team is split into two parts. One is learning and development, second part is culture. The most important aspect, what we are doing, what we are considering now is the talent development, skilling and reskilling. That is very, very important. So we have functional trainings and we have soft skill training. We have tied up with many institutes. We have career development plans, as I said, individual development plans for key resources. For example, for air conditioners, steam, for product managers, they need to be upgraded. What are the latest technology? Today we are coming with smart air conditioners. We had, of course, it was our mistake, we did not market it well. We had an air conditioner Nano G. So the technology was that as you enter the house, the air conditioner, you know, turn on immediately, automatically. And when there are two people, it will improve the efficiency. When there are three people, it will again improve. But when there is a dog entering, it will not improve. So it could read between an animal and a human being. So that was a technology. If you talk about technology, you know, now we have face recognition. Panasonic provides the best technology in the world. If you talk about lithium and battery, it is the best. So, this answers your question.
Good evening, sir. Sir, here. Sir, left hand side.
Sir,
my question for you is that you said in your session, to win, you should be in your value system. So, sir, like an individual person have his own value system, but a company also has their value system. So, how should we align our side with the company so that it will be a win-win situation for both of us?
It is very simple. The value system is very, very simple. You have to be very, very clean, very high on integrity, and whatever you do, it has to be done with conviction. This is what your parents have taught. This is what your teachers, your professors will teach you now. And this is what the industry expects, that whatever you do, there has to be commitment, passion, no cheating. It has to be very, very clear. And integrity is the most important and followed by discipline. So value is something which you possess within yourself. It cannot be taught in one day or two day. It is the learning, it is the grooming which has happened over the years. So you just need to come and you need to be just open. The same question, in fact, while I was coming, we were discussing on the way. So this is value. Because when you enter an industry, there are set protocols. So you just need to follow the protocol. Respect your seniors. Understand from your seniors. So this is what it is. Whenever you do a business transaction, you have to be very, very clear. So we talk about openness, transparency and partnership. So this is the value, that you have to be open with your employees, with your colleagues. You have to be transparent in whatever you do. Don't hide things. And partner. Because when you partner, you should not think that I should gain, the other one should lose. That is not partnership. Partnership is both the parties should grow equally. So whenever as an organization, we do any business with the dealer or distributor, we ensure that if we want to grow, let them also grow. This is value. So this we have learned throughout our life, whether it is at home or it is at college or it is anywhere.
Good evening, sir. Sir, here straight. So you mentioned about be ethical, but don't you think in the business world it is survival of the fittest? So can you please define ethical in your terms?
Dwara repeat karna please. Dheere dheere thoda.
You mentioned about be ethical, but don't you think in the business world it is survival of the fittest? So can you define ethics in your terms?
I just responded to you, him. My reply is same for this question also. Ethics, business term kuch bhi ho, ethics se upar nahi ho sakta. Agar aapka protocol kehta hai ki yehi tarika karne ka hai, you should follow that. Because what will happen if you take a shortcut? Because in the age of compliance, if you miss a compliance, if you get into cartel or anything, you will be reprimanded. You will be penalized. So maybe at times it will take certain more time, but you should follow the right path. Never get into shortcuts. सो सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. लोग कहते हैं, कहावत है, व्हेन देयर इज सिचुएशन यू हैव टू अडैप्ट. अच्छे, इसको पॉजिटिव सेंस में लो आप, टेक इट इन अ पॉजिटिव सेंस, नॉट इन अ नेगेटिव सेंस. ओके
सर, टुवर्ड्स योर लेफ्ट.
हेलो सर.
यस सर, डाउनस्टेयर्स. सर हियर, डाउनस्टेयर्स टू towards your left, sir.
Hello, sir. My name is Adhish. My question is, in previous years, Panasonic entered the smartphone market with their Iluga and Ray product lines, both online and offline. But later on, we didn't saw any more products from Panasonic. So what's your current plan to counter the market leaders like Xiaomi, Realme, Oppo, Vivo, Samsung, etc.?
Good.
Thank you, sir.
We are not going to go very aggressive in Panasonic for smartphones for the next 2-3 years. Because our strategy is to get into lithium and battery and other businesses, and Panasonic is not doing business the smartphone business globally. It was India where we are there, but we are doing only enterprise. So we are going very very slow because mobile phone, it requires a big investment. That investment, we think that the energy is going to give us more, because that is the future. Because electric vehicle is going to come. Charging stations is required. So we are going to invest there. So that is a strategic decision where we have purposefully, we are going very slow, but we are not getting out of business. We are there in business. We are doing a lot of supplies to the government and the enterprises, but we are not that aggressive in the offline and online channel. So our focus is to focus currently on lithium and batteries and other businesses.
So one question, sir. My name is Siddharth. You said that company is doing quite well. Like, but the energy that you create is from the nature. So what is the stand of Panasonic toward nature and environment, sir?
Yes, very good question. So, Panasonic is a 100-year-old company. We just celebrated our 100th year. And the philosophy of Konosuke Matsushita is that whatever you get from the society, you have to give back to the society. So we have a CSR team and they are really doing a wonderful job. In the area of sustainability, in the area of e-waste, we have a big budget. Of course, there are compliances by the government, but we are doing much beyond what the government is doing or expecting. So, if you talk about green environment, I think in a factory, every year we plant thousands of trees. Recently, there was a green environment day, we participated in a big way. So, it is not coming from here, but from our parent company, Japan. And we have a very, very strong foundation led by Konosuke Matsushita, and we believe in that. So that is in the DNA of the organization. Being a Japanese organization, these people are very, very committed towards society.
Good evening, sir. The question you had told a story about pencil box, and there were two important lessons. Experiencing sharpening from time to time and always try to upgrade yourself. What is the difference between the two?
Sharpening from time to time means whenever you go through a grind, accept that grind. Whenever you are in college, you'll be in college, you'll go through a grind, a very difficult grind. Be ready to adapt yourself, because whatever you are going through, the pain, it is going to pay you back. So that was what I meant. And what was the second thing you asked?
Always try to upgrade yourself.
Yeah. With that statement, I meant that you have to keep learning new things. Now the dynamics are changing. Technology disruption is happening. The VUCA world is there. So you need to learn from your atmosphere, from the environment, from your colleagues, from your peers. So you have to keep continuously learning. You should not feel that, okay, I have studied this. This is fine. This is the end. There is nothing end. Every time you have to upgrade yourself. You have to learn yourself.
Sir, myself, sir, Tarang Soni. I have read in an article that 50% there is an increment in the employees in the Panasonic company after 2012. And on the other hand, Panasonic is also working on smart industry business. So can you enlighten us with that how they both are going to work together?
50% what you said?
Increment in the employment after 2012.
Yes. See, when we set up the plant, it was 12-12-12. 12 December 2012. That was the date when we started the factory. And when you set up a factory, you generate employment. So we set up the air conditioning plant, we set up the washing machine plant, we set up the welding machines. And recently, last year, we set up the refrigerator plant and the automotive plant. So that is how the increase in manpower was there. And what was the second question?
Smart industry business
is the welding business, welding automation business. So we have just recently we have done a merger. So there were two companies, and because in global Panasonic we are based out of Osaka, Japan. So globally there are four companies. We have appliance company, we have connected solutions company, we have automotive company. Under automotive company we have multiple companies. So we have merged these two companies. So when you say of automation, so in factories, you know, you have rotors, gears, motors, you know, you have those conveyor belts, SMT machines for manufacturing mobile. So many of the mobile manufacturing companies have they have our machines. So that is the division which sells these machines. Yeah.
Hello, sir.
And then welding machines. We have robotic welding machines where a human cannot enter. These machines enters and they do the welding. Yeah.
Sir. Yeah. Left. Sir, my name is Tejas Samar. Actually, you mentioned a point about Panahomes in Japan. So, how aggressively is the company thinking about establishing its market in India? And how long will it take to fully acquire the market or like have good sales in India?
Very good question. Please have a seat. In Japan, we have a colony. We have developed a colony. And it is fully operational. And from Japan, we moved to Indonesia. There we have experimented. It is doing really very well. In India, recently we have hired the team for Panahome. We have had a solution with the anchor team, and we are doing a big project with Brigade in Bangalore. You know, Brigade Builders. You would have heard people from Bangalore. They might be aware. So Brigade Builders, with them we are doing this project. It will take some time in India, because we are doing some experiments, because a lot of investment is required here, because most of the things will be imported. We don't manufacture here in India. So we have to look into the logistics part, and it will take 3 to 4 years time, if I'm not wrong. I don't have exact detail, but it will take 3 to 4 years time, because we are still building the team.
Sir, as a fresher and as a very or even having a brief experience in the field of HR, I would like to ask you which of the following will have a better scope in the HR fraternity: being a specialist in one of the functions of HR, or being a generalist HR and adapting to the industry?
Being a business HR means you have to be good in everything what you do, because see, HR is changing. Times are changing. HR is changing. Lot of automation is coming. Lot of, you know, how to say. Earlier the interviews were happening manually. In times to come, it will happen through robots. We call it bots. Artificial intelligence is coming in a very big way. So HR will only be respected when HR will work very closely with business, and business will find value in HR. So earlier, personal, HR, earlier there was personal department, then it got into HR department, HRM department. Because unless until you add value, nobody is going to give you that recognition. So business HR is the most important thing, where you define the policies, you work closer to business, you help them to find talent, you help the business to, you know, groom people, retain people, motivate, morale, a lot of things are there. So it has to be a generalistic thing. Otherwise, what will happen if you choose one area, you will go and you will hit the roof ceiling and you will not be able to grow.
Thank you, sir.
That's it? Yeah. Okay. See, what happens, please have a seat. Actually, what happens, you know, when, if suppose as an organization, if I go and if I advertise on Naukri.com or any portal, we'll get thousands and thousands of resumes and we can pick from there. When you go to a campus, And when you pick people from there, there is a certain expectation that the person will come because the company invests. In our case, we invest 1 month. So there's a rigorous training. Once you join, all the business heads, they come, they spend time with you. Then we send you outside for outbound programs. We invest heavily. Similarly, many companies do that. If somebody is investing so heavily, and in all the forums, they are saying that, you know, and in, during the interviews, people say that, you know, I'm committed, I'm going to continue, I'm open for any job. But after joining, if you have a set of mind, no, this job is not meant for me. No, I will not do this. No, I want to do this. Or indiscipline. Or you work for a year or so, then you say, no, I want to change. What happens? The entire strategy for human resource planning goes for a toss. And people feel that the youth, they have a lot of potential today. You guys have a lot of creativity, a lot of passion, a lot of energy. There's no doubt about it. But it has to be channelized. It has to be channelized. There's no doubt about it. So the problem the industry is facing today is stability. You should not be in a hurry. Jaldi ki koi baat nahi hai. You have a long career. When you join industry, at least minimum 30 years career you have. And you should plan your career for every five years. 5 years I'll do this, I will gain this knowledge, I'll like to experiment this industry, I want to go here, I want to do this industry. You change industries. But at least you should spend some time, 4, 5 years, 6 years is very important. At least 5 years. My first job, I spent 5 years. Second job, I spent around 13 years. Now, 6 years. I also keep on getting interview calls. Come and join. But no. Till the time you are enjoying, till the time you are delivering, till the time you are learning. And I want to be a student throughout my life, frankly speaking. You have to be a student throughout your life. इंसान का जन्म हुआ है तो आपको तो ये लेके चलना पड़ेगा कि जिंदगी भर सीखना है पढ़ना है. So this is very very important. So ऐसा कुछ बड़ा वो नहीं है, but yes, at times they feel that why should I go and hire a fresher? You know, we invest so much and after 2 years they say that we are moving out. So we all face that challenge. So I just, it's a word of caution that don't be in a hurry. So you have now 2 years, work very hard. Education is very very important. That will give you an edge. And I'm very sure the kind of rigorous training these guys are going to do is going to help you. Yeah.
Sir.
Yeah. Excuse me. Let this be the last question for the evening. Thank you.
Good evening, sir. My question was, over the past few years, we have seen that Panasonic was working a lot in robotics. So, as the situation now has arisen about artificial intelligence, so what's the case? Is it going to develop something in that field as well or continue with robotics only?
Yeah, it was working in the area of robotics in Japan and the US market because all markets are very different. If you go to US, they do a lot of work in avionics. प्लेन में कभी भी आप ट्रैवल करोगे और जो पैनल होता है टीवी का वो पैनासोनिक का ही होता है 90% ऑफ द टाइम. सो दैट सॉल्यूशन इज गिवन बाय द यूएस टीम. इंडिया पे रोबोटिक्स पे काम नहीं हो रहा था, इट वाज नॉट हैपनिंग. लास्ट ईयर वी हैव सेट अप अ इंडिया इनोवेशन सेंटर एंड वी हैव हायर्ड अ बिग टीम ऑफ यू नो इंजीनियर्स एंड वेरी वेरी यू नो कॉम्पिटेंट प्रोफेशनल अंडर द लीडरशिप ऑफ CIO, दैट इज द चीफ इनोवेशन ऑफिसर. And we are going to take it forward because we are in the process of creating smart solutions. Because we have all the products. AC say, TV say, home appliances say, energy, fan, sab kuch hai. Everything has to be connected. Smart house. So whenever you walk in a house, you know, your system will talk to you. If your air conditioner wants to get, you know, attended, so it will give a message. So that is it. Yeah. See, बिजनेस में ऊपर नीचे चलता रहता है, इट हैपन्स. टेस्ला के अंदर इन्वेस्टमेंट बहुत बड़ी होती है. पैनासोनिक हैड 118 कंपनीज. वॉट हैपेंड एज अ स्ट्रैटेजी वी डिसाइडेड एंड एज अवर फाउंडर सेज दैट वी हैव टू गिव बैक टू द सोसाइटी. सो वेन द एंटायर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वॉज आई मीन द इंडस्ट्री वॉज मूविंग टूवर्ड्स यू नो LCDs एंड LEDs, Panasonic continued to spend in plasma because plasma is good for eyes, for viewing. LED and LCDs are not very good because that affects your eye. So, as I said, that was the philosophy, but people did not like it. People like LED and LCD. So, we suffered big loss there. Then we stopped that manufacturing of plasma, but the loss was very big because we wanted to give back to the society, answering to his question where he asked, what are you doing for the sustainability and society. About Tesla, yes, it is very difficult time, but definitely it is an investment because the future is EVs. Electric vehicles are hone wali hai. Toyota has signed up with Suzuki. They have a joint venture. Mahindra is doing a lot of work in the area of EVs. We have done some launches. If you go to Google and search Nimbus, you'll get a product about Nimbus. Recently we have launched Nimbus. That we hired few engineers from IIT BHU 2 years back, and that has been developed in India by these engineers. And Japan was really surprised how you guys can build that. Very small team of 4 or 5 people, they have done that. Electric charging vehicles, stations.
Yeah. Sir, at balcony. Sir, you told that always play to win. Then now recently you said that do things in a good or right way. But my question is, if a situation arises that you have to play violently if you want to win, there is only win-win situation, and it has to be play with in a wrong way or in a violent way which can harm your company or your peoples also, then what should we do to win that game?
Again, please repeat your question. I did not get your question.
Okay, sir.
Dheere bolo.
Okay. Sir, you told always play to win. Then now recently you said that do things in good and right way. Okay. If the situation arises that if you want to win, you have to play in a wrong way or a violently way which can harm your company or your employees also.
World Cup match dekh rahe ho cricket ka bhi? Jeetne ke liye khel rahe hai na?
Yes.
We are playing to win?
Yes.
India Afghanistan ka match dekha apne?
Yes.
Dekha tha?
No sir.
You did not watch?
Sir, pura match nahi dekha, sirf highlights.
So you play to win. Matlab, you stretch. But you don't win try to win the wrong way. Why? You will be disqualified. Agar aap ko cheating karoge, jo Smith ne kiya tha, ball tampering ka, what happened? He tried to win with a wrong way. And what happened? He was suspended for 1 year. Answer is very simple. Try to win, definitely try to win. Because when you try to win, you stretch yourself.
Thank you, sir.
Okay then, thank you all of you for having patience.